We're willing to have a conversation about it. In other words, yes. So why don't we cover everybody off? My apologies for the delay.
Can you just describe the different sod of the installation in Cray Kids?
Sorry, the installation in Cray?
Yeah.
I don't know, it's a ground mount installation. I don't know a lot of detail about the Cray installation, so I'm not able to adequately answer that question. Yeah. Yes?
When you're looking at making an investment, putting yourself in charge of it, how do you assess the economics of it? Whether or not it's worth your time and effort, and also what's your anticipated payback period?
Right. So you make a number of assumptions when you estimate the payback period. The most important assumption you make is what will happen to the future of the price of electricity. Because you know you're going to spend the first. We've assumed that electricity prices in Saskatchewan will likely go up at about 5% a year. That's an assumption that so far is being borne out since before. That was an assumption we made 2.5 years ago. But you know, it may not necessarily go that way. If it does, then I would say your payback is in the kind of, you know, the 16, 17, 18 year range. And that assumes some inverter replacement and all of those kind of things. So that's your most important assumption that you make, is that how quickly will electricity prices rise. Obviously, makes a big difference whether they rise at 2 or 3% a year or 5% a year. And of course, the more they rise, the quicker your payback period is. Because, you know, you're on your own home, what you're basically doing is, you know, you're saving electricity, right, by putting in your solar panels. So the higher the residential electricity rate goes, the more money you're saving on your panels. And then for a building owner, you know, the building owner is obviously interested in saving money, and we're interested in getting a significant part of those savings. So when you're working with a building owner, one of the things that you are wanting to look for is a situation in which, given the price of electricity now and given where you think it's going, if you assume a 5% increment, that, you know, that the co-op will be able to generate some revenue from that, and then it'll be attractive for the building owner too. So your panels are going to have about a 25-year life for sure. It might be longer, but for sure 25 years. So by that 20-year mark, that last 5 years should be your best years with higher electricity prices. Yes, sir.
How would you characterize your relationship with SaskPower?
Well, you know, I think SaskPower is getting more interested in solar, and they had some very fine staff who were out doing solar policy consultations a few months ago, and the president of SaskPower came to those consultations, and I think was very sincere about signaling that they want to come forward with some better solar policy in the province. And SaskPower has recently made a public commitment to move towards putting in 60 megawatts of solar power in Saskatchewan. So I think things are changing in SaskPower in an exciting way between the time we formed the co-op and the present time. And I'm hoping that, you know, SaskPower will be, you know, very supportive of a co-op establishment here. But I think it's a new field for them, you know. But at the scale that we're operating at right now, it's not like it's competition for SaskPower or anything like that. But I tell you what will be competition for SaskPower is if, you know, I would really like to see SaskPower move in a big way into helping homeowners and businesses install solar. And SaskPower might even want to think about doing those solar installations itself. Because 20 years from now, when the price of solar is cheaper than fossil fuel generated electricity, if SaskPower doesn't do that, SaskPower could end up losing customers. You know, so like it was right, if you look at solar costs keep coming down, then there's a risk for SaskPower that ultimately, and this is not going to happen in the next 5 years or anything, but you know, 15 years from now, it wouldn't surprise me if fossil fuel generated electricity in Saskatchewan was more expensive than solar. And a whole bunch of people are then doing their own solar installations and their own battery storage, and they don't need SaskPower anymore. And the whole idea of setting up SaskPower was to serve the people. So I think part of that serving the people needs to be helping people reduce their greenhouse gas footprint, helping the province reduce its greenhouse gas footprint, and doing that through facilitating people investing in renewable energy, including solar.
And is your sense that there is that willingness and interest at SaskPower?
Well, I think it's starting to shift, and there's certainly a number of staff at SaskPower who are very interested in this. We'll have to wait to see. I think the real indication about where SaskPower is going on this, well, the first positive piece is the 60 megawatt commitment. A lot of that is going to, you know, it's being basically divvied up three ways. 20 megawatts is kind of for bigger solar projects. I suspect a lot of that will go to out-of-province developers. 20 megawatts is for First Nations Power Authority and work on First Nations Reserve. That's a good investment. And then 20 megawatts is community solar. And that's what the consultations at SaskPower were doing a few months ago were about, is what's that community solar piece going to look like? And we provide a lot of input to SaskPower on what we'd like it to look like. If they come up with a really good community solar policy, that would be very exciting for everybody in Saskatchewan, and certainly for groups like the co-op here at the Florence and our co-op in South. So we just don't know what that piece is going to look like. I was hoping we would by now, because those consultations were in the spring, but there hasn't been an announcement yet, and I do understand that things within government at times.
Sorry, I think we're
going
to have to, we'll have time for more questions. We're just going to take time to go over our survey, which will take 10 minutes, and then we'll move over, because the guys with the instruments want to move back over here. So we're going to switch spots. And but yeah, Peter, thank you very much.
Oh, you're really welcome.
So I'm going to do this when I'm teaching, so I'm just going to project things and I'll talk from here. Hopefully that's okay. I just want to go through this really quickly. Again, this was as of 5 o'clock today, so there's 46 respondents. A few disclaimers. I threw this together. I realized that there were some questions that were left out. There's some that could have been better worded. I look forward to you joining our leadership team. And that's going to be one of my points. It's due time that we get more people involved in the planning and what we're going to discuss and all this stuff. I'm really looking forward to that. So I just want to go through as the questions that we had, and just quickly so you guys have an idea. So like I said, this was 46. I'm guessing more of you responded to this already today. How important is it that we only purchase solar panels made in North America, even if it costs more money? You guys can see there, the top is very important, the middle is somewhat important, and the bottom is not that important. Okay. Now that I've listened to Peter's presentation, and a couple other comments you guys made, I think some other questions would have been, how about the ethics of the solar panel?
Thank you. Thank you.